Hey guys, what is going on? It's BeckoningCow here, and welcome back to another Magic the Gathering Arena video. So, first of all, I just want to thank everyone who subscribed in the past couple of days. My last video did pretty well, and a few of you subscribed off of it. So I would like to just thank all of you who did for that. And also, if you haven't subscribed yet, go down below the video and subscribe. Also, feel free to drop a like and leave a comment with any questions you've got about Magic Arena, this deck, or just anything in particular. So, with that being said, let's get into this deck. So, I've just been playing around with Jund Food at the moment, just kind of because I think this is the best deck in Standard, surely because not many people are playing it. It's really underrated and it does well against quite a lot of the meta decks. So, especially the Sacrifice decks and the Mono Black decks. It also is alright against Team Reclamation. That's kind of its biggest, weakest point. But still, with the sideboard, it's quite easy to win against it. Because we've got the three Cindervines, which are very good destroying the Wilderness Reclamation. And also, whenever they do cast their non-creature spells, it deals damage. So if we get a couple of these on the battlefield, I mean, it's pretty much over for them. Also, Thrashing Brontodon's really nice against it as well. Also, against like the Simic decks and the Nissa decks, Massacre Girl to sideboard is really good. And we've also got quite a good, because there's less interaction, we can pretty much do what we want. So when we get a Mayhem Devil, a few Witch's Ovens and a Cauldron Familiar, that's kind of what we're looking at for against Simic decks. Mono Black decks is kind of the same thing. Just to get Mayhem Devils, I think Witch's Oven and Cauldron Familiar is like the main thing against Mono Black. It's just brutal against them. And also Trail of Crumbs. Trail of Crumbs is good in every matchup. I mean, just getting those like card draws just to keep our engine going, it's just really good. Especially against Team of Reclamation, which is generally like a more card drawy matchup. If we get a Trail of Crumbs, we just outdraw them, we win the game. Because Team of Reclamation wins by drawing into its bombs, such as Explosion Expansion, and the Reclamation, and is it Fastest Intervention, I think? And this deck just does really well against all of them. So, also, I added, since the last video, I'll link it here, I have added Liliana, Dreadhorde General, to the deck, and I've taken out a... so I've adapted the sideboard, I've changed the sideboard around, and I've also added a Liliana to replace Casualties of War. That's because Casualties of War was really good against the Mirror Match in this deck. However, and like kind of Simic decks as well, just a little bit. But there's been a reduction in the amount of those decks being played. So Liliana just works a lot better just to create tokens, get a bit more card draw. And also, each player sacrifices two creatures. So that is really good, if I could just find it for you now. So that is really good when you're playing against Azorius Control. So that is really good against this Dream Trawler card, because they can't give it Hexproof. Basically just this mass removal, because this will be one of the only creatures they play. So say they have two of it on the battlefield. This Liliana is very good against it, because it makes them sacrifice that creature. I mean, not many people are playing Azorius Control. However, you have to prepare for it. And also, it's good against other decks with minimal creatures, or just it's for 6 mana, drawing a card whenever a creature I control dies, so Cauldron Familiar, so more card draw with that engine. And also just creating zombies every turn, it's just really nice. And then if you can get to ultimate it, I haven't yet, but you can make each opponent sacrifice all permanents they control apart from one of that type. It's just really good. And with this deck, I have actually managed to get two... go to profile section, I have managed to get to diamond. So this will be my first few games in the diamond rank for you guys today. And yeah, let's see how I get on. Go into my first game in diamond rank. Let's hope it goes quite well. All right, so this is actually an okay hand. I'll start off by having Stomping Ground tapped. And then I'll follow up by two Witch's Ovens on turn two. We are relying on a land. Or another mana source to get to the Vraska Golgari Queen. Okay, we're playing against an aggro deck. This isn't a great hand against an aggro deck. However, I feel this matchup is just generally suited towards... generally, like, it's pretty good against these... against aggro decks. Just because if I can get the Cauldron Familiar Witch's Oven combo off... Okay, Stormfist Crusader. I quite like that because I am currently relying on card draw. It's good for him, but it's also really good for me. So, I don't need the Witch's Ovens yet, so what I'll do is I'll just end my turn, just because there's a chance he will have, oh, there we go, a second Murderous Rider. It's looking a lot better for me now. What I'll do is I will, let's just destroy this Stormfist Crusader. he will be able to hit me for an additional point of damage, so 4 points of damage. I think there's one card in it which is like if you deal 4 points of damage. Oh, it's the Knight of the Airborne Legion. Also, getting these Murderous Riders out onto the battlefield. Okay, Spawn of Mayhem. Once again, I'm not really going to complain about that. But I am going to kill this on my turn. We're hoping to hit our land drops here. So what I'll do is I'll just play out the Murderous Riders. Hope he doesn't have any more Mayhem Devils. If he's got more Mayhem Devils, it's a bit of a problem. However, okay. Drew a bit, so I have a feeling. Alright, well, this is so. Here we go. The Mayhem Devil go here, although Cavalier of Night and Vraska are both really good cards against him. Yeah, so there you go. That goes. Okay, so we get our Blood Crypt in. Playing that in tapped. Then we'll just put the Murderous Rider down. Oh, we could have played Vraska to kill the Rotting Register there. That's a bit of a misplay. Ooh, hopefully that will not affect us too badly. Just put this in front, just gain the life off of it. We're not going to open ourselves up to any spectacle costs. Hopefully, that wasn't so bad of a misplay. Okay, alright. So, play a Fabled Passage and we'll put Vraska down. This has a convert amount of cost of 3 or less, so we'll destroy it. Just very nice for us. And then we'll sack this, we'll get a forest, we're running, like, low. Well, when I say low, we're not running low on them, but, like, there's not as many as we would like. So then next turn we'll take 4 points of damage down to 9. That's if he chooses to target us. Hopefully he doesn't get an Ember Cleave. That would suck. Yeah, so he's choosing to kill the Vraska. So we take 3 points of damage here. And then next turn I'll play the Murderous Rider, just because it makes his attacks, well, not as good. Yeah, so Murderous Rider, and I won't play the second Witch's Oven, there's no need for it. It also leaves us able to sacrifice the food. Okay, Black Clan's Paragon. So next turn we'll gain 5 life. So we won't actually end up taking anything, I don't think. Pass to end turn. Okay, we both draw cards. Okay, Gilded Goose, that's alright. I quite like that for us currently. Pass to blockers. So, here... What we'll do is we'll block. Or if he's got the. So he can't block that, so we'll block this. Pass the first threat damage. Okay, so he didn't actually have the. I was basically playing around Ember Cleave there. Like a fool. Absolute fool. Okay, Rotten Register. Okay, that's nice. That's really nice for us. Because we could play the Gilded Goose. So sacrifice this, gain ourselves 3 life, going up to 7. We'll get ourselves a Mayhem Devil. There's no point for another. So play this. Then we'll play ourselves a Gilded Goose. Then we'll play this Cavalier of Night, sacrificing the Gilded Goose in order to kill the Rotting Regisaur. We won't sack this because we can just get another trigger off of it with Mayhem Devil. Okay, yeah, let's see what he does in terms of attacking. Pass to blockers. Pass to damage. Okay, yeah, because obviously we can't kill it. Okay, Gutter Bones comes down. Right, this is fine. So let's just go for... Well, this is actually looking really good for us. I think we can board wipe him this turn. Yes, we can. So we play the Mayhem Devil. We will have to sacrifice. Dealing 1 point of damage here. Getting ourselves a swamp. And then we will sacrifice again. Dealing a point of damage here. Getting our black land. Then we'll go to combat. Swing with this guy. Getting ourselves up to 8 life. Actually, I will say this is a difficult one. Depends what he draws. Actually, no, whatever he draws here, it's probably better if I just keep the Cavalier of Night up just in case he gets the Rowing Register. Sorry if I'm sniffing this video, guys. I've got a bit of a cold currently. Pass the damage. So it's only taken us down to 5. If he's got an Embercleave, we do down to 1. But I can sack the food. So what does he have? He's got a Spawn of Mayhem. See, this is where I'm kind of glad that I kept my Cavalier of Night in hand. Also, it allows us to be able to... So we get an extra, like, kind of... Not trigger so much, but an extra point of damage. So, sacrifice, food. Yeah, what we'll do is we'll just kill the Gutter Bones, which is untapped. We'll pay this... Getting ourselves a Paradise Druid. We've got a land in our hand for next turn. Anyway, then let's just go to my turn. Now, play a forest, play ourselves a Paradise Druid. Very nice. Then play the Cavalier of Night, sacrificing our Paradise Druid to kill the Mayhem Devil. So we deal 1 point of damage here. And we will destroy the Spawn of Mayhem. Then we swing in for 7. Next to combat, swing in for 7, gain ourselves life up to 12, and yes, I think we win the game here, because in our graveyard we have the Mayhem Devil. This is returned mana cost 3 or less, so we sacrifice this guy to deal 1 point of damage to him. Getting ourselves the Mayhem Devil back, dealing 1 point of damage here. Then when we sacrifice the other Cavalier of Night, we deal another 2 points of damage to him, just close out the game, just to make sure we win on our turn. Obviously, if I sacrificed the Cavalier of Knights and then didn't kill him, it leaves us open. But because I knew we were going to kill him, it just makes it a lot easier. Okay, so because we're playing against another ramp deck, an aggro deck, we'll play the Massacre Girl. Also, Wicked Wolf could be nice in this scenario, and I will add in Thrashing Brontodons to... Actually, will I? Because obviously, Embercleave is very good against us. I'm just wondering how good it is. So I think Liliana is good in this matchup. Cavalier of Night is amazing. This is amazing. Murderous Rider is really good. So I think it's just a case of just like cutting down on some of our more rampy cards. And I think this is good. We could just try and kill the creature which the Embercleave has put on every time. Because this deck does have a load of like lower toughness creatures. And if we could just kill them, then it just makes it a lot easier for us. This is a very good matchup for us. It always was in a previous standard, Rakdos against Jund. And I'm assuming that this Rakdos deck does pretty well if this guy's playing it. We rely on a bit too much with that hand. This is a really nice hand. What I'll do is I'll just put the Fabled Passage into the... Do I? Let's see if I that or the Liliana. But I like the Liliana here. So turn one, I'll play the Fabled Passage. Then turn two, I'll be able to get Cauldron Familiar, which is over online, which is going to get Rotten Regisaur. Yeah. I could have dropped a Cauldron Familiar, but looking at the hand, I don't know how I'm going to draw, of course. Okay, Stormfist Crusader. Once again, we like that. It does deal both of us, endure both of us damage, but I mean, all things considered, like being in the position I'm in, I do quite, actually what I can do is I can Cauldron Familiar twice just to prevent the profitable swing from him, because we can kill his Stormfist Crusader and then next turn play the Witch's Oven Gilded Goose. Because he's obviously thinks that I'm just going to. So if we block like this, the next turn we could play Gilded Goose and still bring out the Cauldron Familiar. It might be that he's got a pump spell. No, he just gives it Death Touch and lifelink, so he gains himself 2 life. But we take that card and then we're on the front foot here. So here we'll play the Trail of Crumbs. And do we want to gain the extra card or do we want to... I think enabling the combo is better for us here. Because also it seems like if he attacks, I'm just going to block it and then sack it. Yeah, let's just go to... Let's just pass the turn to him. If he plays a Rotting Regisaur, I'm quite happy with that. It's just in the scenario... Okay, destroy target artifact. Well, that sucks. But I think the better thing for him to kill here would have been my Trail of Crumbs. So in that regard, I'm pretty happy. Okay, let's just sack it like this, kind of try and bait out the attack from a Black Lance Paragon. Then it's in his court, maybe he plays a land. Okay, so he's missed his land drop here. Okay, so what we'll do here is we'll actually play the second Trail of Crumbs. And then just go to him, because we could draw 2 cards off of this. And I like that. Okay, he plays the Ember of Shieldbreaker in response. Let's play our Cauldron Familiar, draw 2 cards. I think this game is kind of, well, it's over for the guy now. Pretty much. We get our land. It's just to kind of be able to guarantee the Liliana. Resolve that. My turn. Let's sack this, get ourselves a red source of mana. We can play our Liliana next turn, no matter whether we have. So, next combat, attacks, and turn. And then we could just make basically like make this game work for us now. Exiled that, so. In response, we want to kill one of his creatures here, so we'll get the Black Lance Paragon out of the way. We don't want him to be able to bring this back to a hand. His hand with the Flying Knight, whose name eludes me currently. Okay, now what do we get here? We get another Mayhem Devil. I'm not going to bring Massacre Girl in. It just doesn't seem to work very well for us in this matchup. So yeah, exiles that. Okay, that is fine. So what I would actually do here is I'll go to combat just with one of these guys, leave the other one up as a blocker. He could choose to trade if he wants to. No, goes to damage. So we'll play our Mayhem Devil and I'll leave this up as a I'll leave this up to kill. Actually, do we want to leave it up? No, we'll just bring the Gilded Goose down so we can draw the cards if he chooses to swing. This is where we're just kind of praying. Actually, no, we're not even praying he has a mask. He doesn't have a Massacre Girl here because maybe he's got another Murderous Rider. Okie dokie. So what we'll do is we'll just kill his creature here. He's going to kill us. We'll help to start kill him. Start kill him. Very good English for me there. Start to kill him. Then this turn we'll just drop the Liliana, and this kind of just seals the game here. Then play Blood Crypt tapped, and we go to swing with these two. We're not going to swing with the Gilded Goose, obviously, because that would do nothing. He might be able to deal with our Liliana. No, he just looks at it, decides to concede, and we put ourselves up forward into Diamond Tier, gunning ourselves right towards Mythic Rank. Okay, so we're into our second game of the episode here. This hand looks good. We've got the Gilded Goose, the Trail of Crumbs, which is obviously not the preferable combo, and now we've got the Mayhem Devil to go with. So next turn we'll play the Trail of Crumbs. Hopefully this isn't a blue source. Yeah, it is. Okay, hopefully there's no quench. Omen of the Sea. Okay, nice. So we kind of had to hedge our bets there that we weren't going to get mega screwed and countered there. But no, we're fine. So bottoms these two. Okay. Then we will go to combat and no attacks and end the turn. So we'll see what he does here. We're in a very good position here because we can now just get our engine online and just keep drawing cards. Hopefully he plays a Teferi here. Vanishing Light. Okay. Sacrifice of Hood. So we want to get this done at least once. That's kind of a bit of a bummer for us. Okay, so we take ourselves a Castle Locthwain here, just so we can get a little bit of card draw later on into the game. Okay. So we can play this tapped, just play a Cauldron Familiar, Witch's Oven. This is such a nice combo against control decks because they can't do much about it. And yeah, see, there we go, he just quits, concedes the game, because there's nothing Azorius control can actually do about that combo. So let's see what we do. So Noxious Grasp can be good against Teferis, however I don't think it's pivotal. Wicked Wolf could be nice to give it indestructible. Oh no, he's just conceded the game. Well, I'll take it. If they hate the game that much, let's get into a third game. Alright, well, into the third game of the video we go. And well, the previous two were, I'm not going to say easy, but they weren't too difficult. So at worst we go 2-1 this episode. I don't like the look of that. It's too much reliability. Alright, here we go. This is a good hand. Let's just get these out of the way. I don't really want to be taking any damage when I don't know what I'm up against. But this is just like, this is a nice combo for us because we're able to draw ourselves some cards. Boreal Grazer. Okay, well this is a nice matchup for us. If this is Simic Ramp. Yeah, there you go. Sabrina Pool. So he doesn't have a temple in hand. That's a nice thing to like think about and kind of remember. We don't need to play our Witch's Oven this turn because, well, we kind of want to leave what's in our hand to it. It's a bit of a... Oh, I should have drawn a large card. It's my bad. What I'll do is I'll get a... I'll make up for that today. Another one. OTP. Let's get another Trail of Crumbs. And what we can do is we can play our Stomping Ground and Trail of Crumbs. And which is it. Then end the turn. So this is a very nice position for us. All we're kind of doing is looking for something to kill a Nissa if it does come down. My turn. Alright, so here what we do is we sacrifice a food, adding a black, it doesn't matter what colour it is. Resolve, auto pay. We get ourselves another Gilded Goose if we've got more than enough land in hand, and then we'll auto pay. So that taps the swamp. We don't really want that. We want to tap the green source. We've got ourselves a Mayhem Devil. That's pretty nice. I like that for us. And then the Mayhem Devil comes down. This could be nice to kill the lands that Nissa produces. So we're just kind of looking for our Cauldron Familiar here now. So if this is a Nissa, okay, so it's a Cavalier of Thorns. I like playing against Cavalier of Thorns a lot more with this deck, simply because we just get to block it with the cat, and it just doesn't do much. Okay, so he gets the Scry land in. It's nice that he's not got the Fassa. Attackers. Do you want to swing in with your Boroglazer? I'll be happy to block it. Okay. Mayhem Devil comes down. Fabled Passage. Let's just sacrifice. Add a black. Actually, we're not going to be able to play it anyway, so... Or what are we? He's seen it, so I'll play it. We can still draw the two cards anyway. Next attackers, attacks, end of the turn. Alright, so we're just looking for a cat here, basically. If we get a cat, we're in a very good position. Hopefully he plays his Nissa. Pass to attackers. Oh yeah, of course he'll swing in. So, pass to blockers, no blocks. So, we're not at the point at which we're going to have to start throwing chump blockers in front of it, because we're still at kind of a relatively healthy life total. There's another Cavalier, okay. So this is where it starts looking a little bit worse for us. What's in his bin? Okay, so he's got a Fassa. Okay, so a Hydroid Crisis on top would suck. Like, suck real bad. Okay, and Leaping Druid. Alright. So, let us sacrifice this. We can just kill his source of mana. So let's get ourselves a black land. Then what we'll do, sack tap, sacrifice, add a black mana. Kill a leafkin and deal 1 point of damage to him. Then resolve, auto pay. Getting ourselves a Witch's Oven. Okay, add auto pay, hopefully getting a cat. No. So what we'll do here is we'll get a... Let's get another Witch's Oven. Let's kind of just ramp the card drawer up a load. Let's go to my turn. Come on, let's pray. Pray for it. Okay, we don't get it. Okay. Alright. Well, let's go for a cat. Let's see if we can get one. If not, it might be at the point at which we start having to just chuck. Best he can play. Alright, let's just deal the damage to him. Alright, resolve. Auto pay. Cavalier of Night. That's actually pretty good here. Auto pay. Getting ourselves a Paradise Druid. Auto pay. Getting another Paradise Druid. Oh, we could have taken the Korvold there. That would have actually been really good. Ah, what a misplay. So what we'll do is we'll just get ourselves a Paradise Druid in. Oh, we've misplayed so badly this game. And turn. So what we'll do is we'll block one of the Cavaliers with the Paradise Druid. We're just hoping to get a few cats here. Nice to attackers. Swings in with these two. Pass to blockers. Let's get a Cavalier. A Paradise Druid in front of here. And we get ourselves right, can we actually deal 13 points of direct damage to him? So next time we can swing in. I think we... No, not yet. Not yet. If we get a cat, if we draw a cat, we need to draw a cat, and then it's possible. Okay, so he gets a Nissa down. I'm not sure why I didn't play that first. Okay. Well, we can still try and have another Cavalier of Horns. This is looking awful for us. There's no point in sugarcoating it. Like, thoroughly bad. Alright, so we get 1 point of damage. So let's just start. Okay, so what do we want to kill here? So we could kill a Cavalier of Thorns, but that just gives him a great turn. So I think it's just imperative to kill the Nissa currently. So, auto pay. There's a cat. Love to see it. Auto pay. Fabled Passage. That's also nice. So if we get a cat, so it enters the battlefield, deals 1 point of damage. So then it gets 2 triggers off of this, so that's 4, so that's down to 5. So that's 6. Okay. I'm going to decline this here just because I think I've got enough direct damage. Okay, so Cauldron Familiar comes in, deals 1 point of damage. We play the Witch's Oven, get more damage in. So let's see how much damage we can deal with the Cauldron Familiar. Otherwise, I think we lose. Actually, no, we don't lose. We don't lose because we could just throw chump blockers in front. So down to 2. Then this will take another... Yep, I think we've got him here. It was a bit of a struggle getting there, but we do... We have gotten him eventually. Decline. Shall pay... Pay 1. Get a forest. Decline. Sacrifice a Cauldron Familiar. 1, 2. I think we actually kill him exact. One, two. So we get 3 points of damage up here. Decline, decline, decline. So he's dropped a nice. Sacrifice our Fabled Passage. We get another 2 points of damage in here. So that was a clutch Cauldron Familiar off the top. We were searching for a little while, so that we got one out of the top 23. So I think that's fair enough. So in this sideboard, actually, against Nissa, I think the best card we've got, so we play, obviously put in Noxious Grasp. Massacre Girl goes down. We do put in an epic downfall. What we take out, we take out Vraska, just generally awful in the matchup. Liliana, the Sax, it's just not that good. Then what we also do is we take out Noxious Grasp. We don't want to take out Paradise Paradise Druid, just because... Actually, we take out 1 Murderous Rider because we've got... Actually, we'll take out 2 Murderous Riders. We'll just play it like that. This should be, like, more than good enough to beat him, and then we... Hopefully, we could win this matchup. Just asking myself if I actually did put the Paradise the Massacre Girls in, and I'm praying I did, because if I didn't, this will be tough, because he will have, yeah, he'll have a lot. But that was us mulliganing down to a 5-lander against a ramp deck. Not a 5-lander, sorry, a 5, like, 5 cards in hand. Because obviously the first, I think the first hand we had there, what was it? It was a Murderous Rider and a and the cat. And then we had five lands, but none of them were like good lands. So I don't even think we had two swamps to be able to play the Murderous Rider. So I think it was then good to mulligan that hand. And the second hand I had was a bit dubious because it was okay, I think. I seem to remember it's okay, but it just didn't have the right combo pieces I needed. Or any combos, in fact. So, I mean, our final hand, it had the Witch's Oven, the Cat, and the Trail of Crumbs. I mean, the Golden Free. That combo is just brutal. And then hopefully this Zek Esper guy is going to lose to us. I mean, he could come back. I mean, this Simic Ramp deck, it's a very tight matchup between us. I do think Simic Ramp does edge it in the end. However, post-sideboard, I think the pre-sideboard is the best game for him. So to win that one is a massive win for us. Just post-sideboard, it's a bit tougher. Okay, he goes first, so we're on a draw. Yeah, we'll keep this. Just because if we get a cat, and we need a forest, really. A forest and a red source. Boreal Grazer, hopefully there's another land in his hand. It reduces the chance of him having anything actually good. Alright, Witch's Oven. Because obviously we're going to have to go a little bit longer here. I'm hoping he doesn't have that 1-1 elemental, which is when elementals enter. Okay, he missed his land drop. Ooh-hoo-hoo-hoo. Let's get him. So next turn, we play Mayhem Devil and the Goose. Okay, Risen Reefer. That is, like, that's fine. So hopefully he just draws a card. Okay, plays Brina Pool tapped. Alright. Things I love to see. Things I love to see. So let's pick 1 point of damage towards the Risen Reef here. And then I think we can just control this game from this point. We've got the Murderous Rider for when he plays the Nissa. If he plays the Nissa. There is the Nissa. We've also got the ability to kill the land from a Nissa before we play. So he swings in with the land here. We take 3 points of damage. Pass the blockers, no blocks, pass the damage. Okay, and from this point we're just in a very, very, very good position. So obviously he can't counter us with just the island on board, but we're going to try and. So what I will also try to do here is I will try to bait out the block of the Arboreal Glazer. Actually, no, I won't. No, I will not. Okay. Island for the boy. Then I kill his Nissa, and I have a feeling this will just be a straight quit. Sacrifice this. Let's ping him for one. I don't think it's to the point where we need to start trying to focus damage onto. Then let's just play the and then we'll also play this for the Paradise Druid. He can't really kill it directly, so it losing the hexproof. Let's just go for a good game. And turn, see what he could come up with. So he plays a tap land, so he can't play Nissa this turn, which is pretty crucial. Just bottoms it. Whatever he plays now, I can kind of deal with. Shifting Ceratops, protection from blue. Well, luckily enough, I'm not blue. So he plays Cauldron Familiar. deal him 1 point of damage. Yeah, and he just quits. So I think I'm going to wrap up the video there. I've been recording for 40, 45 minutes now. And for our first three games in Diamond, we have managed to rank up. So we're now in Diamond Tier 3, charging towards Mythic. And hopefully I've been informative for you guys as to how to play this deck and also how to just rank yourself up towards Mythic. I've been trying to put in a lot more time into Magic Arena to get myself up to Mythic just for better content for you guys. And if I could also ask you, if you've made it to the end of the video, well, of course you have if you're listening to me now, please could you subscribe? It means ever so much for me. Leave a like, comment, and all of that stuff. Yeah, thank you for watching the video, and have a great day. Goodbye.